Fourier transformation is used in many areas of science, engineering and physics. In this video, we'll look at how the Fourier transformation is used in the reconstruction of MRI data. Fourier transformation is a fundamental part in the reconstruction of MRI data. Data acquired by the read coil in an MRI system is in the time domain. In MRI, we refer to this as case space. In order to transform this data to something we recognize as an image, in the frequency domain, we use a Fourier transformation. To understand how this process works, we'll look at a simple one-dimensional example. Here we see a simple waveform in red. The red line shows amplitude in the vertical axis and time is in the horizontal axis. We generally use the notation f for this data. We can approximate nearly all time domain data by summing a series of periodic sine or cosine waves of varying amplitude. We have overlaid the set required to approximate our original time domain response here in blue. Note that these can all be expressed by a single formula, shown below the graph. In order to Fourier transform this data to frequency space, we expand the set of periodic waves we used in the time domain as shown on the right in blue. Note that the height of lines along the frequency axis corresponds to the amplitude of each of the original waves. We can now see the Fourier transformation result of our original waveform in blue. We use the notation f hat for this representation of the data that is now in frequency space. This example shows how the case space data of an MRI acquisition looks. On the left we see the case space of Fourier domain data and on the right the resulting image. We have overlaid how our previous one-dimensional example would relate to this example. In the one-dimensional case, amplitude is shown by the height of the bars, and in the 2D image, the amplitude is encoded by the brightness of the voxel at each point. Here we show how the data in case space relates to the reconstructed image. In this example, we have artificially removed all the case space data except a small part in the middle. Note that the resulting image only shows the larger parts of the image with no fine detail. This is because removing the high-frequency time domain data in case space will result in an image with only the large structures present. By increasing the amount of data in case space, we can increase the detail in the image. Note that as we continue to increase the amount of information in case space, the image will continue to increase until a certain point beyond which adding more data will no longer add any features to an image. Some scanning sequences take advantage of this effect by only acquiring the central portion of the image and then zero filling the remaining section and reconstructing an image. This increases the speed of an acquisition. Another technique that is often used to increase speed of an acquisition is to acquire only half of the case space data and then mirror this to the other side. This image shows how this will affect the acquired image on the right-hand side. Note that while we can still see most of the image detail, it lacks the clarity of a full case space acquisition. These techniques are usually only used when imaging speed is more important than image detail. A good example of this is in heart and functional imaging.